Welcome, please, firstly to the blue corner from Morocco, Mohammed Achahboun.
Well, the action's underway, and what a scenery we've got. Julie Kitchen next to me, kickboxing talents, the very, very best up-and-comers. Stay tuned, don't go anywhere, kickboxing talents.
We're in for an exciting evening.
We are. Now, that was nice, wasn't it? Very nice of me saying that, Julie, because I'm a very nice man. Anyway, so, as I said, we are in the Hague, or as Pete said, we are in the Hague, and we have some of the very, very best up-and-coming talents here on Kickboxing Talents. I'm Vinny Shorman, and with me is the queen of Muay Thai, the queen of everything in some people's eyes, Julie Kitchen. Julie, what a show we've got here on Kickboxing Talents.
Oh, we've got such a lineup this evening.
Look at you
very
stamping
excited.
Your legs.
I love it.
You've got to love it, ladies and gentlemen. We have got a tournament, and also we've got a ladies' contest to decide who is going to Enfusion Reality Season 5 in Koh Samui, Thailand, in the beautiful island of Koh Samui. Or at Super Pro. And don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, you can keep up to date with what's going on in the Enfusion world. www.enfusionlive.com. Julie, we have a sparkling show for the ladies and gentlemen, don't we, this evening?
We've got an amazing lineup, and as Vinny said, if you want to stay up to date, also join our Facebook page, EnfusionTV, and you can see the schedule for our channel and our what's up and coming.
Well, there you go then. So, as you can see in the background, they're just lacing on the gloves, but this happens, it's live, and things go wrong. We have the youngest referee in Holland at the moment. Rashid, only 23 years of age, and he's the understudy of one of our favourites, Mr. El Hamzoui. So, as I said, a very, very exciting heavyweight tournament coming up. We've got some heavyweights. We've also got a very smiling, excited Cornish lady. We've got a fat middle-aged Mancunian, me, Vinny Shorman. We have an absolute sparkler. Don't go away. We're just waiting for some gloves to get wrapped up, and we'll be getting with you as soon as we can.
The action will be starting.
We have the very best referees in the world here. Frank Tiaus. Mr. El Hamzoui, young Rashid in the ring there. We have only the very, very best.
We've got such a strong team, haven't we?
We certainly have. And here he comes. We have seen him before, haven't we, this
big
guy?
We have indeed.
And he wasn't the best, was he?
I'm not sure if we've seen him.
We have seen him lots of times.
Yeah, I know we've seen him.
On fighting rookies, but he's not the best, is he? God love him. But he's got a lovely beard. And we'll see.
He's really come unprepared. Trousers undone.
Julie, you're on the wrong show, love. You're on.
Please welcome to the red corner from Holland, Tony.
Tony Yasser makes his way to the ring for the Thai boxing. Then had 103 kilos. He's got a window cleaning company. And earlier, his son fought on the undercard and was very, very good indeed.
Yep.
Son and father fighting the same show. An unusual thing, isn't it, Jules?
Yep, must be stressful at home to the build-up.
So he's got his trousers undone ready, apparently. That's the way you prepare for a fight, ladies and gentlemen. Julie Kitchen says, undo your trousers. That proves that you're ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you, firstly, fighting out of the blue corner. He brings a record of 13 fights, 11 wins, 4 of those wins coming inside the scheduled distance. With 2 draws, he's from Morocco, where he is known as the Goliath. Please welcome Mohammed Achahboun.
You know what, he's only 22 as well.
Very young, isn't he?
Yeah, really.
Opposing him, fighting out of a red corner. He brings a record of 6 fights, 3 wins. 3 of those wins by way of knockout. With 2 losses and 1 draw. He's from Holland, where he is known as the Hague Rebel. Please welcome Tony Yes.
He looks like Will Ferrell, doesn't he?
He does. He's got great support here, though, tonight.
Yes, yes, indeed. So, Goliath versus the Rebel here on Kickboxing Talents. And we're going to see what transpires here. This is a tournament, isn't it, Julie?
It is, and tournaments are always exciting, aren't they?
They are, indeed. And coming up later on is two ladies fighting for a place in Season 5 Reality. Coming from Thailand, Enfusion Reality Show.
It's only limited spaces, so they have to fight their hearts out.
We've already got ours, though, haven't we?
We'll be there.
Unfortunately, Kieran Kendall won't be. And in his place will be Andrew King Golden Tate. So a 3 2-minute round contest. The final will be 3 threes. And Goliath, does he really need any introduction? The bigger man, obviously. And the rebel. 3 2-minute rounds. Big boys battle here in The Hague. Round one, then.
Really strong left body kick to start the round. And again.
Scoring without using his footwork well. He has to.
So I imagine Tony's going to be light on his feet moving around.
Yeah, well, he is. That left kick. Mohammed just rumbling forward.
Yep, just standing in front, taking the shots at the moment. Obviously, because of the way Tony is going to have to stay covered. Goliath, 140 kilograms.
He's a big lad, isn't he? Right hand, left up to the body, and a leg kick just bounces off.
Nice low kick.
Goliath Mohammed. I mean, you know, he's going to be intimidating, isn't he? Just lumbering forward. It's like hitting a big bag, isn't it? You know?
That's right. He's not going to be as active, but he's going to be dangerous. At the moment, obviously, Tony just picking up the points.
I think Tony's moving very well. Good side-to-side lateral movement. Has to not stay in one spot.
He has got the harder game, though. He needs to work, move.
Achahboun, though, needs to cut the ring off instead of following him. He's following him around instead of cutting the ring off. Good hard left hook from Mohammed.
Keep his head up.
Good right hand to the side of the head. Yes.
So that's what he's got to be careful of. He's only got to land one shot. Goliath is so big, as we can see now, these shots are big.
Nice combinations going in for Yas. Just bouncing off Mohammed. Right hand, a jumping knee to the chin.
So I see this going two ways. Points decision for Tony. With Tony being knocked out.
I think he'll get stopped here. To be fair, big first round for Tony. Obviously scoring, moving very well, but it seems to me the writing's on the wall. And Mohammed's already tired. I mean, come on now. You know, he needs to get in real good shape for this. I know he looks physically doesn't look the best. But nevertheless, hard knee from Tony. Julie sinking into the big midriff.
That's it. Just on the replays there. You see Tony just edging in, but these are the big shots. Jumping knee.
The thing is, Judy, what he throws well. It's just, you know, massively. You know, he doesn't look great, does he? You know, let's be honest. But there's also a fighter out there, ladies and gentlemen, we haven't seen him, called Ismail Lazar, who it looks like, you know, he eats for a living. But I tell you something, really, really talented guy. So it's not what your body looks like, it's what you can do with it.
Yes, definitely.
You know, so if you look at me, I look like a, you know, an athlete, but
You hide that well.
I hide what well?
You look like an athlete.
Shut up. So, round two, that couldn't think of anything, that's first ever. Round two then, Mohammed in the black and white round in the black shorts, Tony Yards.
You see some redness on the right side of the Goliath. The body shots and kicks have been coming, but he's dangerous.
Yeah, he's extremely dangerous. You've got weight behind you, like he has.
He's looking for the shots as well now. It's only going to take one clean shot. But Tony comes in, starts to open up, but he's leaving himself open.
Good heart, though, hasn't he, Tony, just going in?
He's not frightened of
no,
him
he's
at
not.
All.
No. George, isn't he?
From the Goliath.
Mohammed. He can't sustain an attack because he hasn't got the stamina. That's a problem. That's the problem, Julie. He hasn't got the stamina. Big overhand right.
Tony just has to stay out of danger. Circle around, throw shots.
He's not cutting the ring off Mohammed at all. He's following him round. There's a sneak left hook. He could, if he sustains the attack, he can get Tony out there, trust me. But he's too... Like, he's not in shape, is he?
He's not. I mean, he's tired now, and he's literally just walking around the ring. Not throwing too much. Tony put the work in.
So you got to give credit to Tony, but he's sharp.
But he is leaving his hands down low. He's got to keep tight.
Nice straight right to the body. Good one upstairs. Good boxing from Yas.
The thing is, I think you can hit the Goliath all day and it's not going to affect him so much.
It's not going to affect him, Julie, but it doesn't win fights.
Exactly.
You know, getting hit doesn't win.
This is good work from Tony, but he's leaving himself
wide open. He's writing on the wall when he can push a man that big back. It is writing on the wall, this.
He's got to come back with something. Goliath's got to pull something out of the hat. He needs to work.
Big round for Tony, wow. Two rounds in the bag.
He's still in it.
Yeah, I thought, you know, if he can sustain the attack, Mohammed, he could get him out of there, trust me, but he can't because he's just not in shape. And he's not cutting the ring off. He's letting him move around and score, so this is the way it goes, man. It's just... He's moving really well, Tony, and that was good. It was fine as well. He just turned his back momentarily.
Yeah, he's really pushing forward. As we said, he's not frightened of him. He's putting the work in. This round, he just needs to stay safe.
Yeah, he does.
Obviously, Goliath's tired, so he's less dangerous this round.
Well, he's going to really have to go for it, Mohammed Achahboun, isn't he, the Goliath? Because Tony in the back is scoring. And Will Ferrell. Welcome. Moving around as we go into round three then here on Kickboxing Talents.
Just getting his gum shield back in. Ready for the final round.
Here we go then. So round three then.
Round three.
To go through in this tournament. So this is the reserve fight at the tournament. There you go, Tony. Right hand. Really, he's in big trouble now, Julie.
He really fell down onto
he's
that kick.
He's in really big trouble here.
You
now,
can
if Mohammed goes for this, Julie, he can take him out. I did say, if he can sustain an attack, he will get him out of there.
I believe he's in danger.
He really is.
He needs to get out of that corner. He's got to use the footwork.
Mohammed's got to put pressure on. He's walking after him too slow.
Has he got the fitness, though? Tony's coming back. Knee's coming right up. It's shaking
him. He scored a count, Julie, and it could even the round up, so they could have an extra round.
He's still working, isn't he?
Give credit. He's not throwing enough, that.
Nice uppercut.
Got to give credit to Tony. He's got good heart. Oh. Gum shield's come out.
He didn't realise it was just a gum shield.
It's a reserve fight, sorry, ladies and gentlemen, four to be in the tournament, so.
Well, 40 seconds left.
It's got to go.
Oh, very nice left knee from Tony.
He gives up, though, doesn't he, Mohammed? You know, if his shots bounce off, he kind of gives up. You can see him lose heart after he's thrown a combination.
He's got to work on his fitness, hasn't he?
Yeah, it's ridiculous. I'm not saying he's not tough, I'm not saying he's not strong enough, I'm just saying, you know, he needs the fitness now and he certainly hasn't got it.
He's dangerous. When he pushes forward, opens up, he's a dangerous man.
Tony scoring. Nice knee by Mohammed. Again. He's not cutting the ring down.
Well, I'm very pleased Tony made that three.
Yes, so am I.
Deserved to.
But we'll see. There may be an extra round here because... An 8 count, a 2 rounds to Tony. We'll see. He get some of the action.
So this is where Glyve did start to open up, throw some punches and the kick. And then he got a result of hurting Tony. He really needs to work on his fitness so he can just pursue a bit more forward in the ring.
Yeah, but like I said, I mean, you know, I'm not going to lie because it upsets people. It's not intended. But if you're not fit enough and you're not in shape, you can't do it.
Even as a heavyweight.
In any way, you've got to be fit, haven't you?
Yes.
You know, and he clearly isn't fit enough. He's fit, but he's not fit enough. And, you can see that. So there could be an extra round here.
Well, the gloves are coming off both fighters.
Right, okay, so there's not. So I'd give it, who would you give it to? Tony?
Yeah, I give it definitely to Tony.
Well,
he definitely put the work in. He wasn't frightened, pushing forward.
No, he wasn't. Here's the decision then.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, your judges have reached a unanimous decision. Your winner, fighting out of the red corner.
Well, there you go, yeah.
Tony, the main rebel.
He deserved that. Yeah. Back to the drawing board to Muhammed, but I'm not saying he's not talented, but if he got himself in better shape,
please say your appreciation.
It might be a threat. Great performance by Tony. Yeah, I mean, you know, as far as I'm concerned, he did really, really well. And fair play to him. And he's the reserve fighter that goes through, just in case there's any injuries.